Where did you get this from? Sakusa's eyes were blown wide open as he finished watching the video. Iwazumi opened his mouth but Ikoa interrupted him before he was able to say anything. They had a gig in a small bar downtown. They are called Gemini as far as I remember and they do have some other songs uploaded. Look. Gemini. The one with the golden mask. The lead singer I guess? He's fascinating. His voice is divine. Sakusa looked through some more videos of Gemini and sent them to himself via Ikoa's phone. Find them. Huh? I blinked at Sakusa blankly. You heard me. I want to make a song with them before anyone else will discover them. How selfish. Ikoa said with a shit-eating grin and Iwazumi snorted. We'll tell Kenma about it. Maybe he can like. Search them up or something? Yes, sounds good. I'm going to listen to some more of their songs. Their music seems to be similar to ours. We would fit quite good if they are willing to cooperate. Yeah, that's why I sent it to you. Sakusa rolled his eyes but grinned at Toru's cockiness. I still want to listen to them live first before we contact them. Ikoa gasped. You don't believe me? You're no musician, Ikoa. But my boyfriend isn't. Since we're together, that makes me half one. That doesn't even make sense. Sakusa said deadpanned while Iwazumi chuckled. Alright, alright. Coming for a smoke before you look for more of their songs? No, it's bad for the voice. Drag Suna out of the recording studio and tell him about our plans. Iwazumi saluted while he pushed Ikoa out of Sakusa's room. Will do. Don't get too invested. Iwazumi said with a smug grin, warning a middle finger from Sakusa before closing the door. It was good to see him back like this. Full of euphoria, eager to write more songs, to share his creativity again. It's been a while since he's been like this. Yeah. Last person he was so obsessed with was Kagami. That bitch just left him once she got famous. She knew full well Kusa was head over heels for her and she just pretended to be in love. I hate her. Iwazumi chuckled. We all do. Iwazumi wrapped his arm around Ikoa's waist and pulled him a bit closer while they were walking to the exit of the building and Ikoa snuggled even closer to Iwazumi. I just hope he doesn't have to go through the same thing again. Iwazumi hummed and lit his cigarette. He took a drag and exhaled deeply as he watched into the distance. Wish I never promoted that bitch. Iwazumi chuckled and gave Ikoa a chaste kiss on his cheeks. You helped her and us too. Don't worry, I feel like this cooperation with Gemini could actually help Kyo to finally get over Kagami. We just need to find them. Did you check their social media? Ikoa threw Iwazumi a deadpan look. Of course I did. Look, oh shit. That prick still has my phone. Ikoa said, his eyes blown wide open. He hurried inside and Iwazumi chuckled, shook his head while he exhaled deeply. Freaking addict. Atsumu settled down on the couch with a sigh as he just finished setting up the instruments. He let his gaze drift to Sakusa's guitar and then picked it up. Atsumu stroked the wooden part and discovered a branded inscription that carried the name Sakusa K. Omi. Atsumu shook his head. None of this made sense. He couldn't get his hopes up. He was just one of many. Sakusa had had his fun with him, and maybe Atsumu felt so special because Sakusa was a fucking star, after all. But this between them was never anything serious. How could it ever have been? It was obvious that Kayumi was still attached to his ex. From what Atsumu had caught of his colleagues' gossip over the past few days, they told him that Sakusa was the one who had made Satou Kagami big. She was a beauty, a megastar, had an incredibly good voice, and was now at least as famous as Lethargy, or even more famous. Sakusa and Kagami had been a couple. She was his makeup artist back then, and when he listened to her sing one day, he had convinced her to go on stage with him. One thing led to another, they got together, made some music, until Sakusa was able to persuade the bosses of BKK Records to support Satou Kagami as well. And like famous people do, they were in a long-distance relationship because they were both on tour in different places. Sakusa had surprised her, and well, he had surprised himself too. He found Kagami with her clothes stripped half off, in the lap of the band's bassist with whom she was touring. The band was even more famous than Lethargy, that bitch was just out for the fame. Sakusa had loved her. He really did. She was one of the few he could open up to, where he could be himself. So watching her cheat didn't just break his heart. He literally fell into a hole that he couldn't crawl out of for 10 months by now and tried to distract himself from her with alcohol, sex and music. And that's what Atsumu was. Distraction. Atsumu strummed on Sakusa's guitar, humming the new song of him and Osamu while his fingers put on an insanely good acoustic version. Atsumu was lost in his music, started to sing, letting his mind run free, until suddenly someone snapped him out of his trance. No way. You're the lead singer of Gemini. Atsumu's stomach dropped. What? I'd recognize that voice anytime. Hajim. You'll never believe me. Atsumu quickly put the guitar aside and hastily stood up. He rushed to Okoa, pulled him into the instrument's room and slammed the door shut behind him, leaning against it. Okoa looked at him in shock, his eyes wide open. Holy fuck. Aren't you Okoa Toru? The one and only. Okoa Toru. He was an influencer, supermodel, and a megastar. He was always good at talking and being handsome. He knew how to put himself into spotlight and he knew how to promote things well. Since Okoa dated Iwaizumi, Lethargy had also gotten a heavy increase in fans. Atsumu was a fucking ordinary sound engineer. How did he manage to get in touch with so many famous people? So Gemini lead singer. Atsumu. Okoa raised an eyebrow and looked questioningly at the blonde. My name. Atsumu. Cute. Atsumu raised his brow and gave him an annoyed look. We have to tell the others about this. They are going to freak out. Oh god, Kiyomi will be amazed when he finds out. He can't find out. Huh? Okoa was snapped out of his rapture and looked at Atsumu in confusion. Sakusa. He can't find out. Why not? Atsumu swallowed. He didn't want that. He didn't want to owe Kiyomi any favors and he certainly didn't want to be like Sakusa's ex. No, if Gemini was ever going to make it to the top, it would be by their own efforts. Besides, Atsumu loved his private life. Yeah, all the hustle and bustle with the fans was kind of cool, and yeah, he had to admit that he felt kind of special when he was performing with Osamu. But he also enjoyed not being on TV or on any magazines right now. He enjoyed not having rumors spread about him. He enjoyed that he could just be who he was. Meow Atsumu. He sighed, ran his fingers through his hair, and pushed himself away from the door. Atsumu pondered how to explain to Okoa that Sakusa couldn't find out about him being a singer. Telling him that he had a thing with Kiyomi? No fucking way. It's... Okoa, you've got your damn O. Atsumu? Sakusa interrupted the two as he entered the instrument's room to give Okoa back his phone. He had heard him calling for Iwaizumi, so he just followed his voice. He hadn't expected to meet Atsumu here, though. You know each other? Sakusa smirked. Of course we do. And Atsumu blushed hard. Hey. Hey. They stared into each other's eyes, Kiyomi literally devouring Atsumu with his look. Atsumu's lips parted as if they were ready to sink into a passionate kiss with Sakusa Kiyomi. Okoa watched the two closely as he got his phone back and could see Atsumu's gaze completely lost in Sakusa. How he literally adored him. How visibly nervous he appeared. Okoa now understood why he didn't want to tell him. Atsumu had an incredible crush on him. And it would be such a waste if Sakusa didn't know about it. Hey Kyo, you're going to be a judge in that music competition in a month, right? Yes. Sakusa didn't take his eyes off Atsumu, making him even more nervous. Which made Kiyomi's heart flutter seeing the soft pink appear on Atsumu's cheeks. Cute. Blondie here wanted to participate. Atsumu tore his eyes open as wide as he could and jerked his head towards Okoa, just looking at him in shock. He wasn't fucking serious right now, was he? Sakusa raised a brow and eyed Atsumu, who had turned his gaze back to Kiyomi and was looking at him in surprise, kind of caught off guard. You can figure something out. Can't you? Sakusa smirked again. Sure. I'll put you on the list of participants. Atsumu swallowed. No, stop, wait. Perfect. And he needs some practice too. Do you think you can help him out? Atsumu babe doesn't want to embarrass himself. Atsumu narrowed his eyes and now looked at Okoa in absolute annoyance and disbelief. This shithead knew exactly how good he could play the guitar and seriously just what the fuck. Tsumu babe. Motherf. I don't know if that would provide an unfair advantage to our blondie here. Sakusa said while brushing a strand of hair from Atsumu's face and smirking wider and wider at him. Red was no longer an expression for whatever that was on Atsumu's face. Oh come on Kyo, you can't resist that face, can you? Ikora put an arm around Atsumu and took his cheeks between his palms, squishing his face towards Kayumi and holding his own pleading visage next to Atsumu. Atsumu frowned and looked at Ikora out of the corner of his eye with annoyance and suspicion, unable to turn his head due to his tight grip. Sakusa chuckled. Damn that deep low smile. Do you have time right now? Atsumu looked at Sakusa in confusion, Ikora now letting go of his face. Why yeah. Alright, let's see what skills you have. His smirk grew wider and wider. Yes, perfect, then I'll leave you two alone. But first. Atsumu, give me your phone. Huh? Atsumu turned to the side and eyed Ikora, who held out his palm to him and waited for him to give him his phone. Atsumu frowned, but did what the model wanted him to do. Ikora grinned as he held Atsumu's phone in his hand. He typed ambitiously on it, taking out his own in between to type on it, until Atsumu's phone suddenly beeped. A message. Cool, now you have my number and I have yours. Get back to me so we can plan your gig, sweetie. Bye bye Kyo, see you soon. Ikora returned Atsumu's phone and gave him a hasty kiss on the cheek. Then he put a hand on Sakusa's shoulder. Let me know if you find out about Gemini, will you? Ikora smirked to himself before disappearing from the room. Atsumu's body tensed, his gaze drifted immediately back to Sakusa. They were seriously talking about our band? Of course I will. And with that, he left. Atsumu's palm lingered on his face over the spot that had just been kissed by fucking Ikora Toru. The fuck? Atsumu mumbled and Sakusa giggled. He's a lot. Atsumu's gaze snapped back to Sakusa. The blonde breathed out a smile. Damn, yes, he is. But he's awesome. Ikora likes you, and I can't blame him. And there it was again. That wretched seductive grin of Sakusa Kayumi. Atsumu blush was back in full gear. Grab a guitar, pretty boy. Sakusa grasped his chin and turned that honey-colored gaze on him. Let me teach you how to play. Atsumu looked at Sakusa totally befuddled, ready to kiss him silly right here and then, but this. He couldn't pass that up either. He grinned, mischievous, ambitious, ready to take on the great Sakusa Kayumi. Awesome. Atsumu you. Sakusa fell silent, amazed at Atsumu's talent. He could easily keep up with him, and fuck, it was incredibly fun to play with Atsumu. I didn't know you could play so well. Atsumu grinned, took a sip of water and examined Kayumi from head to toe. The curls that fell chaotically into his face, the edgy features, the two moles above his eyebrow that gifted him with even more beauty. He was gorgeous. What about your voice? Can you sing, too? Sakusa pulled him out of his thoughts. For a moment, Atsumu panicked. I can't. Kayumi raised an eyebrow. That means you're performing an instrumental song? Atsumu narrowed his eyes and turned his face away from Sakusa. What kind of shit had Ikora gotten him into? Why yeah. Right. Instrumental. My brother will assist me. He had to push Osamu into it, he'd never survive this on his own. I see. Well, I don't think you'll need my help when it comes to practicing playing the guitar. Sakusa put his instrument aside and walked towards the blonde. Do you still feel like jamming with me every now and then? Making music with you was really fun. And it was true. Atsumu was a pro when it came to the guitar, making music with him was a whole different level. The blonde smiled and god, Sakusa's heart just melted. Sure Omi, I enjoyed it too. Yeah really good. Sakusa placed his palms each next to the blonde's thighs, leaning over Atsumu so that their faces were very close. Sakusa grinned, whispering against Atsumu's lips. Do you want me to show you where I'm good at, too? And Atsumu grinned back. Whatever it is, Omi, I'll prove to you that I'm better. Sakusa released a breathy smile, hovering over Atsumu's lips. It's on. The month went by quickly and Atsumu and Osamu actually had that shitty performance. Of course, They were the last ones. Are you still sure you want to do this? Atsumu gulped. Too desperate? Osamu gave him a small reassuring smile before shaking his head and hugging Atsumu tightly. Nah, I think it's cute. Atsumu hugged him back. Are you guys ready? Ikoa grinned at them, earning back the grins of two confident twins. Yeah. In the past month, Ikoa has become a really good friend to Atsumu. The two of them just hit it off. Ikoa was crazy, and so was Atsumu at least as much. Besides, there was a lot he owed to him. Without Ikoa, Atsumu wouldn't be here now, wouldn't be on the verge of confessing to Sakusa how he felt. The relationship between Atsumu and Sakusa had also developed significantly over the past few weeks. They made an incredible amount of music together. From time to time Sakusa also started to sing, which completely took Atsumu's breath away and he would have loved to sing along. But he had never dared. Making music together led to the fact that they got to know each other better and better, that they developed more and more feelings for each other, because Sakusa was also totally fascinated by the blonde on the guitar. He was truly a natural. They stole kisses from each other, spent nights together and oh god, Atsumu felt like he was in heaven. Until he was brought back down to earth. It was a week ago when Atsumu rejected Sakusa. Rejected him when he had almost kissed him. And why? As once said, being famous is anything but easy. Those shitty headlines haunted Atsumu. Sakusa was seen flirting with other celebrities again, hooking up with them. Atsumu couldn't do it anymore. He had no idea what he actually was to Sakusa. If all this between them was something serious or if Sakusa just wanted to have his fun with him. Things got messy, though, when he rejected Kayumi because of that. Sakusa was disappointed that Atsumu believed the rumors about him more than he believed him, but how could Atsumu know any better? When Atsumu first met him, Sakusa ticked exactly that way. He was completely out of it, yes, but since he had been with Atsumu things had changed in his life. But the blonde couldn't know that. Because they both had never talked about that this between them was something special. And here they were now. Silence between them. Only Atsumu, who hoped to win Sakusa over with his last chance of triumph. With his voice. He's going to freak out as soon as he will hear you sing, Atsumu. Ikoa hugged him tightly and Osamu gave him a weak smile. They could hear their names. Not Gemini, no. They heard Miao Osamu and Miao Atsumu being announced. No masks? Atsumu took a deep breath. No masks. This performance would change everything. Atsumu and Osamu ran onto the stage, cheered on by the audience who were already looking forward to the last performance of the evening. They looked at each other determinedly and Osamu nodded, coaxing a faint smile out of his brother. He knew he could do it. Atsumu's gaze traveled forward to the crowd and oh wow, he really had never performed in front of so many people. Sakusa sat right in the center of it all, furrowing his eyebrows as he wondered why Atsumu didn't have his guitar with him and why Osamu was at the mixer. Atsumu smiled faintly when he found Sakusa's gaze. This is for you, Omi. I was shy, you were fun, let you after dark, the night was young. When you dance, had me sprung. Now we're in the bathroom, shirts undone. Sakusa's eyes widened. There's no way he could forget about that voice. Baby, I wanted a taste that you thought it was harmless. Now I'm addicted, so walking away is the hardest. I keep on touching, I'm touching your body regardless. When I know you're heartless, baby, you're heartless. But I lose my fucking mind when you take off your clothes. I look up in your eyes like, babe, I'm about to blow. Take my body, damn, you take my soul. I lose my fucking mind when you take off your clothes. So let's get naked. Sakusa snatched one of the microphones from one of the hosts standing next to him and headed towards the stage. Can't deny, I wasn't blind. I just didn't want to read. He pulled himself up to the stage so that he could now face Atsumu. The blonde's eyes were blown wide open.
Your clothes. I look up in your eyes like I'm about to blow. 'Cause when you take my body, then you take my soul. I lose my fucking mind when you take off your clothes. So let's get it.
Their faces were close, hands about to intertwine. They smiled at each other, breathing heavily, totally captivated by their voices. Sakusa pulled Atsumu into a tight hug, gave him a kiss on the temple and buried his face in his blonde hair. I was searching for you. Atsumu buried his face in Kayumi's shoulder. And you found me. Everything seemed so perfect. Sakusa's heart was racing. Atsumu had totally overwhelmed him. But then his eyes drifted back to the cheering and raging crowd and saw one person he really hadn't expected to see at all. Satou Kagami. Or also known as Sakusa's ex.